In 1972, Dr. Dagg was unfairly denied tenure.
They said, well, no, you're a woman and we don't hire women. It was devastating, really.
She was the first person to study giraffes, or indeed any animal in the wild, in Africa.
Anne did not go down without a fight. I mean, she took it to the Human Rights Commission.
It has taken 86 years to get here.
The degree of Doctor of Science.
Welcome to Convocation at the University of Waterloo.
It has taken 86 years to get here. Why now? Why not last year? Or even 10 years ago?
I present Anne Innis Dagg. In 1972, Dr. Dagg was unfairly denied tenure after completing a very successful assistant professorship. Her incredible contributions to science and to tackling issues of gender equity in academia are founded in courage, tenacity, and talent.
Here at University of Waterloo, the dean stated he would not hire married women for full-time tenured position, so I didn't even apply.
Anne Innis Dagg, I'm honored to confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Science, honoris causa. And I extend my sincere congratulations.
It was just assumed that whatever I'd done couldn't be any good because I was a woman, and it's weird, really. But that's true.
Anne Innis Dagg is probably the most important research scientist you've never heard of.
Describe for me what this morning was like for you.
It was magnificent. I was thinking negative thoughts because so many universities had not wanted me to teach or anything. And they were saying, welcome back, because I did my university work there and hadn't been accepted as a person after that.
50 years ago, she was shut out of the Scientific Boys Club, and some of this country's best-known universities went along with it.
Why weren't you accepted?
They just said they were a new department, biology, they didn't want any women in it. I didn't really want anything else in life except to be a university teacher. And when it came to becoming a real professor, then there was no place for me.
She was crushed when the job was given to a man who she felt had less qualifications than she did.
Anne's experience caught the attention of filmmaker Allison Reed. Last year, she released a film about Anne, and people began to learn about a decades-old wrong done to her.
It's definitely a deep wound.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think getting the honorary doctorate takes it away 100%.
The film shows that before Jane Goodall began her study of chimpanzees, there was Anne. Called The Woman Who Loves Giraffes, the film uses footage Anne herself shot all those years ago, a 23-year-old from Toronto on her own in Africa in the 1950s.
Well, my mother said, you must go. You've always wanted to, and if you don't do it now, you never do it.
Drawn there by a lifelong love of giraffes, she would become the first person in the world to scientifically study a large mammal in the wild. She admits now she wasn't really sure how to research giraffes. She just started writing down everything they did.
I went out and sitting in the car, and there were maybe 8 giraffes, and then you could look at them all, and they were eating different leaves, and it was what I'd always dreamed of, and here I was doing it and writing notes.
In time, that research led to a book that came to be considered groundbreaking, and she got to work teaching at 3 Canadian universities. But to continue her research, she'd need to be made a full professor. She felt sure she'd earned it.
I'd actually written more books and done more articles than most people because I worked really hard. I mean, I'd written more papers than the head of the department that refused me.
How was it explained to you?
Well, they just said, well, no, you're a woman and we don't hire women and they have babies and why don't they go and look after your babies? So it was devastating, really. there were six of us, all of us had just earned our PhD. We all wanted to work at the university, and they just said, we don't want you. And it was, I remember going along, a woman I didn't really know, but I went along to her room in one of the student residences, and I opened the door. And she just started to cry, and we hugged each other. Because we didn't even know each other, but we knew that sort of everything we wanted and then our whole life was just being destroyed.
When Anne received the news that she wasn't going to get tenure, that meant that she had to leave that job at the university. So she would not have university support to be able to continue her giraffe research, continue to publish papers on giraffes.
It would mean that if you published anything, no one really cared. Maybe they wouldn't even know that you'd published anything.
Anne did not go down without a fight. I mean, she took it to the Human Rights Commission of Ontario and also the Ontario Ombudsman, and lost in both cases, and there were appeals. I mean, the fight went on for 7 years, didn't it? And she lost.
How difficult was it for you to be on the sidelines of your own career?
Oh, it was very difficult. I just hated it, but I decided I'd just work on my own, and so I wrote a number of books and articles, and now I feel very proud about that. I was able to do fighting things that made a difference to me.
It strikes me that while your career didn't take the path that you intended, because it was denied you, in the end, you've actually helped explore and nurture women's rights.
I hope so. I've fought it for them because of my own negative experiences. When I was teaching part-time at the university, we'd gather together and do all sorts of feminist things. I remember flying across Canada at one point and giving lectures at various universities and, you know, explaining we should help women.
Did you ever get pushback for that? People saying, look, this is you just personalizing your experience.
Oh, yeah.
You can't get
they
over
hated
it.
Me.
No, they
well,
hated
you.
You
know, I was just bringing dissension into the university.
When we come back, Anne learns people haven't just been reading her books. She was a bigger star in the scientific community than she ever realized.
What did it mean to you to be discovered?
Oh, I was in heaven. I couldn't believe it. It was just fantastic. It was sort of the happiest time of my life, really.
Anne Innis Dagg has spent her life studying and fighting for giraffes.
So among all of the giraffe-themed items you have, and you've got a few, these paintings are really, I guess, meaningful to you on a much more personal level.
They both were done by Bob Bateman, whom I knew in Toronto when I was in high school. So he was my first person I went on a date with. So
how close is it to what a giraffe looks like in person? Did he capture it?
No, it was pretty good.
She was the first person in the world to study giraffes in the wild, publishing research as early as the 1960s. But Anne was denied a university professorship because she was a woman. She believed she'd mostly slid into obscurity after that. In fact, Anne had become something of an academic rock star in the field she pioneered. She just hadn't known it.
Anne wrote the textbook. Especially when I was doing my master's, she was essential reading.
I think what you didn't realize is that book you had written was considered the Bible. So everyone in the giraffe community clearly had that on their bookshelves, from zookeepers to giraffe researchers and scientists. They all knew you, but they didn't know you personally.
No.
They just knew you from your name on the spine of the book.
Working in this field, there was nothing else really coming out for a really long time. I had worked in the field for over 10 years, and most of what we relied on still was Anne's book from so long ago.
Amy Phelps is the woman who was responsible, I say, for rediscovering Anne. I mean, she said that she studied Anne's book as a child and that Anne was her hero.
Her contribution so many years later was still so great. But in this field where we needed that expertise and we used it every day, we didn't know her. And so it was really important to me that we'd be able to find her.
Dr. Dagg, we are pleased to welcome you again into the alumni of the University of Waterloo.
The film has brought attention to Anne and the animals she loves. One university has now awarded her a doctorate, another has given her an apology. And she's been embraced by the scientific community she once longed to be a part of.
What did it mean to you to be
discovered? Oh, I was in seventh heaven. I couldn't believe it. It was just fantastic. It was sort of the happiest time of my life, really. Now people are looking at books I wrote maybe 50 years ago and they're saying, well, this is really interesting. It's so annoying. Why couldn't they have done that earlier?
You're 86. Truthfully, this apology, this recognition comes past a point in your life when you can make the most of it.
Oh, yes, for sure. Yeah. It's just now an ego thing.
And not frustrating at all?
Well, no, I mean, you know, things are better now and people are responding to me and life is much better than it was.
And she's been back to Africa, matching what she learned then with what's happening there now.
Isn't that beautiful the way it's Lake Skull?
She'd rather forget about what she lost and focus on remembering what started it all.
How close are you?
Quite close, but they weren't really paying any attention, maybe 50 feet.
How extraordinary was that for you, given your love for them?
Incredible to think they were so close. They got used to me, I think.
You do worry about the levels of giraffe that exist in the wild now. I mean, they're a fraction of what they were during the time that you were there.
Oh, yes. They're so endangered. I just thought they'll be there forever. I mean, they're so beautiful. Why would anyone kill them?
The number of giraffes in the world has fallen nearly 40% since 1985, diminished by poaching and urbanization.
Anne, thank you so much for your work and your inspiration. And thank
much has changed for Anne as well. At 86, this woman who's led a quiet life for years is suddenly the star at every screening of her film.
My question is, Anne, have you been the recipient of the Order of Canada? And if not, how can we nominate you?
A nomination for the Order of Canada, just the latest effort to make sure that Anne finally gets her due.
Do you feel kind of rejuvenated by all of this?
Yeah, oh yeah. It's great, because otherwise I would be thinking, oh dear, I'm gonna die. I'm in my 80s. I feel that we should go again to Africa. That would be wonderful.